So welcome all to my talk about debt and release process. That's the perspective of Sarge. Sarge was the last stable release, is currently the stable release. And my name is Andreas Barth. I come from Munich in Germany, and I'm a member of the release team. So the release team consists of 5 persons that are Steve and Colin as release managers. Instead of Frank, Joy Hess and me as assistants. And in the team, we work very well. Everyone has its tasks, and you don't really see the difference, but we all have a common goal, that is to release, or that goal was to release Sarge. It's now to release Edge in time, but I will tell about that later on in this talk. So welcome you all. So releasing Debian. The first question is, why do we do it? There's a very good reason. Our users, they want a stable basis where they can work on, they can deploy their work on, they can install computers. Especially if they administrate more than one system, they often dislike to have one package updated today, the next tomorrow, but they want just to restrict how much administrative work they need to put into. For that reason, Debian publishes stable releases. We traditionally publish them when they are ready. So are we there yet? Yes, we are now, but it takes sometimes a bit longer than we originally had hoped. So the stable releases we had already are from Bass, that's in June 1996, till Sarge, which was in June 2005. Before Bass, there were another way of releasing Debian, but that was, well, I would say the old kind of releasing, and who isn't this and that should read the package Debian history by Bdale. So Sarge now, the current stable release, consists of over 8,000 source packages and over 15,000 binary packages. And from the sheer amount, you can see if we want to release at all, we need a lot of coordination to make that possible. And that's the task of the release team, basically. So what does Debian consist as distributions? We have 4 to 5 so-called distributions inside of Debian. There's sometimes, like now, an all stable. There's stable, that's the current release distribution. There's testing, or the expected new stable sometimes later, unstable and experimental. Currently, all stable is Woody, stable is Sarge, and testing, the next stable candidate is Edge. And for the developers, they usually upload their packages just into unstable. From there, they go to testing if they are there for a certain time and if no problems occurred. And if we are satisfied with the testing in whole, that means not only with the packages but with everything, we make a release and declare it as stable, and the thing that was stable before is then the name to old stable. Well, I want to say something about these things. I just say how it works in general. There are some exceptions that are better documented in, for example, the developer's reference, but I think you're more interested in the general overview, how do we do it, and not in some picky details about what can go wrong in this, for example, testing migration of packages. So who is interested in that should perhaps come to my other talk for the developers. So what are our release standards? A package must not have critical or grave bugs. That means just it must not be unusable, the package or the system, or there must not be security bugs. The package must be also okay from the maintainer's point of view. The package needs to be free, of course. We are speaking about free software, so package must be free. So we must be able to make security support for the package. Then there's a so-called release policy with a lot of smaller issues that are more technical. Of course, a package needs to follow them. That's now the link for the next release policy. The current one for Sarge has, of course, Sarge SE policy. So the installer needs to be ready for a release. We have some release goals that need to be met. So that's more or less what we have to achieve. And what did we achieve for Sarge? What are our improvements from the user point of view? That's, of course, definitely a very good installer. I would say one of the best or the best installer currently on the market, and a very far better than a lot of other installers. Of course, usual, I would say, a lot of better improved packages. Debian improved a lot between Woody and Sarge. But I guess about these things, there are a lot of more things of the user view improved things in Sarge. There are other talks here, so I better speak what's improved release management-wise, technical-wise. Our infrastructure has very much improved. That's the installer, that's easier to cope with than the boot floppies, what the old installer ever were. The kernel has improved very much. For Woody, we had 11 different kernel source packages, which is very well, an interesting challenge to make a security update for them, to put it mildly. Now we have 3 different source packages, one for 2.2, one 2.2.4, and one 2.2.6. So I think that's it can get a bit better. Like we can drop the 2.2 package definitely for next time. We can perhaps even reduce the number of 2.4 packages or so. We also improved with the release team tools. When I started to take a deeper look at the release team, that was beginning of 2004, so it means a bit more than about a year ago. There were not many management tools. The release team could say, okay, we want to put a package into, or the release manager could say, I put a package into testing despite all the things that are not fulfilled. Now we have we have finer tools. I can say, this package should go in even if it's too young. But that doesn't mean that that critical bugs would be ignored. So we are improving our tools there, and that makes it easier for us to manage the release. We have a better bug management functionality. I can get a bug list of say, what are the bugs that really block our release, and I'm only interested in the bugs that are older than a week, because we know most of these critical bugs are solved in a week by the maintainer, and we as the release team don't need to care about them. Of course, we need to care before we say, okay, this is now stable, but we don't need to care about them on a daily basis. We have a better security issue tracking. That's mostly Joy Hess work, which helped us very, very much to know where are we currently, so that we know how long is the way till the release. But of course, what is else in managing a release? So not only is the packages, there is more. And our part as a release team is to make sure that all the release critical issues, they are actually handled prior to the release. And that involves a lot of things that are, well, not so visible. For example, we had the problem this time that we wanted to publish the D images at the day where we release, which is of course a good idea, I think, basically. But we had the problem that we had too less hard disk space at the site publishing the CD images. That is such a small issue that, of course, it was solved quite fast, but there are a lot of small issues, and we must make sure that we forgot none of them, because otherwise we might be a bit spoiled if we try to release and something fails. And of course, the next is, if we make any change to the current testing, we must make sure that this change will not push us back again. If I write it down in this way, everybody will say, okay, of course, that's the right target. But it's a bit difficult to argue that to maintainers if they have a very good idea how they could get their package fast into testing. So the release team has also said, it's a great task to say no way too often, but that's part of our task, and I can live with it. The next one is that we need to search for the release blockers and tackle them. Best is, of course, if we find somebody to tackle them, but in worst case, we do it ourselves. We have to communicate with all the other relevant teams, because the release team just holds, the most important thing that we can do is speak with other people. We cannot directly do so much, so we have to speak with other teams. What is their opinion? What do they consider as blockers? Is there something in the tool chain, for example, broken that needs to be fixed? Just to name something that was very ugly sometimes. And in the end, there are also a lot of tiny issues, like there's a broken package that needs to be removed from testing. There's some packages that need to be looked into why they don't go into testing by themselves. Such things happen, well, but that's easy to, the last one is the easiest one to from the management point of view. So what we have achieved a lot of improvements for Sarge. The question is, what do we want for Edge? We want to have further improvements. We saw some parts where we can get better than we are. So we want that, of course. We can improve the bug tracking tools, because currently a bug is marked as closed at the moment a fix is uploaded to unstable, but our users don't care really for in the end, it's important that the fix is in testing. This for that, the code is already written and it's about to be deployed any day now. The next one is we need to improve how a package goes to testing and interacts with Debian installer packages. There is some handhold needed as of today, and handhold has always two disadvantages. The one is there needs to be somebody who spends time on it. That's always bad because we all have too less time, especially for things that need to happen on a quite often. And the second one is, as long as human people do something, it's easier to just overlook something. So if you can write a program for it, and we say, okay, this makes sure that everything that we want to have is satisfied, we should go that way. There are ideas. I hope that we can deploy them soon. The next thing is, the way the kernel packages interact with the installer has improved very, very much from Woody. But still, there's some way to go to make it even better. I hope we do it. And the last one, what we really want to do, and I'm quite optimistic that we do this, is you want to release on a time-based schedule this time. We say you want to release in December 2006. I'm quite sure we will. And for that reason, we reduced the number of release blockers as a release team to very few issues. There are only like 4 issues, and 3 of them are technical. So that's, not too hard. I think not too many. And the most other things that I would really like to see it in Edge, that are just pack release goals. I hope they will made it. If it's only 1 or 2 packages that hold it up, perhaps they might become even a release blocker later. But for now, they are only release goals so that we don't miss that timeline. So I'm quite optimistic we make it this time in that way. So that was now most about, I think, the release process. So we have still some time left for questions from you. And welcome to that. So I ignore now the Debian project leader. Any other question? Okay, so.
Something else than technical, and I wondered what that was. If you could say something about that.
Okay, so now I really need to reconsider what it was because I don't know from my memory currently. We have to change the toolchain. That's just as it happens. The toolchain means the compiler, C libraries, has some change, and with a new version of the compiler. That's already happening as of now. There is X.org happening. The mirror split and the addition of AMD64's architecture. We have the doc in main situation. The toolchain I would say is fully technical. The X.org is I would say definitely a user wish, but also a bit technical. The doc in main is just a conclusion of where we as a release team didn't have any opinion on it because we just have to do it.
It's not technical at all.
It's not technical, yes. But in my opinion, more of the things are technical things that are about to happen. And the X.org transition, for example, just happens as of now, more or less. So there's nothing where I really would say it's. Oh, I just hope, Brendan, that you won't say no now. So you would have agreed here in front of public.
No.
So
is this working? Okay, yeah. It's mostly in David Nussenow's hands. So I can't speak for him, but an idea that had been bouncing around in my head lately that would seem to dovetail pretty nicely with this was I have fond memories of. Several years ago when VA Linux did their Slink and a Half release. And because we might want to have some trial runs of release processes, I was wondering if there were a way we could do preview releases, say just to throw out a couple of dates at random, Sargent 1/3 in December of this year, and then Sargent 2/3 in June or July of next year, to give a kind of a trial run of the automated release process, you know, making sure that there's room for the CD images and the other things we would overlook, and to get some real testing of the further infrastructural improvements that we'll be seeing. And the point of this would be, the benefits of this would be not just that we would get some testing of these pieces of infrastructure, of a more automated release process, but that it might provide a way to address the concern of our user community that 18 months is too long to wait for a release. I know from my work with Progeny that this is a very long question, isn't it?
I don't consider it a question; it's a call for that.
Yeah, it's an idea, and I just put it out for some brainstorming and consideration. From my work with Progeny, that enterprise users are they push very hard for long but predictable release cycles, whereas the desktop community, of course, they want things to happen more quickly. So I was just wondering what your thoughts were on that.
But okay,
is it complete bullshit? Should we just not do it at all?
Well, okay, so there are actually two to three questions. So please let me separate them. The one question is, can we have a better preview of what happens at a stable release with our release procedures? And there's something to say. A stable release didn't happen as often until now, so I think about 6 times till now, or with the current tools, that even only about 3 times till now, so that we don't have as much experience as we perhaps wanted. There is something we definitely learned from this year, at least in my opinion. Well, I would just say there is still discussion going on, so I can't speak and say the release team has the opinion that. I'm speaking what I consider currently as an interesting way to go, or as a good way to go, but discussion will show if this is the way to go or another way. But one part or one idea in the discussion was to say, okay, actually we do the release on some date, we just push it to some hidden mirrors. We build the images from these mirrors, and our core team of QA, consisting of 10 to 20 people, tests really everything after that. That means, say it takes the CDs that are hidden, installs, and only if that works, we say, okay, it's released. That would mean for some of the Debian developers won't be too happy with that, because that means there will be no deinstall done for about a week, but I think we can live with it. But that's just one of the discussion ways that we can be sure that how do we release, and if we release, really everything works. And the only way I think we can do is if we really check it. And checking means we do the technical speaking of the release. We don't show it to all of our mirrors, but only to one or two that selected people have access to. We check it, and if everything works, we publish it. That would be the way to go. Because the breakages that have shown this time were not on the package basis level. Packages were all working fine. But there were things like, this time the images were built before the release actually happened from the content of files. So the CD images picked up a wrong release file and made a mistake in the security thing. We learned from that, definitely. There's more than one thing we learned from it. We learned also something else, because the way this entry was composed was perhaps not the best way to do it. So we had 2 issues, and if we solve one of them, it would work. We will also solve even both of them.
Well, if we had these semi-official milestone releases, I mean, we could do basically what you're talking about, except they just wouldn't be hidden. They would be unsupported.
Yeah, well,
I mean, are you afraid there'd be too many eyes upon them instead of too few?
There's something else. It's a moment. What you say is, I definitely disagree with saying we have some testing as status of some date and push that and keep that separate on the mirrors, because in the moment we do it, we call it it's stable. So if we can do that, we do it and we call it stable. So the question, and the question is just, for all of us, what packages are concerned, I think we were pretty successful with this time. We started to slow down the progress of packages from unstable into testing, and we slowed it even further down. And in my opinion, it worked very well, with exactly one exception. That was that we were not able to successfully track all the bugs that solved in unstable but not in testing. And that we are going to change, as I said before. That's one of the process improvements we need for Edge. So I was, in that way, how we dealt with packages, I was really happy this time. It worked way better than I had expected, frankly speaking. So that's something that really worked, and if something worked, I don't see a reason to change it. So what didn't work was the final bits, like changing the content of the release file on FTP master, and that just needs to be detected. And if you have seen the, I would really say, crazy run people's write on Segwit and getting the CD images a bit before. That was, well, not the best perhaps, yes?
I think we are getting a bit deep into the technicalities of this. We could probably come back to this at your... it's all right.
Okay, just let me say one sentence on the second question.
All right.
The second question was, how is it for our users that want shorter release cycles? What we are currently aiming at, a bit at least, is what Joy Hess is aiming at, is to make sure that all the testing really fulfills the release criteria most time. The testing has a quite fast fix of security bugs. And if companies are interested to be really up to the speed, then it might be interesting to run testing. I won't recommend to run testing as of today to companies, but I hope that we can get to that in about half a year time, 1 year time about that.
So you don't think we've really realized the full potential of testing yet?
Yeah, we can get more out of testing than we do, definitely.
Okay. Getting back to Brendan's initial comment that he liked the Slink and a half that came from VA Linux back then. Comparing back then and what we have now, I think that in a sense, we could say that the Ubuntu releases are those and a half or and a third release, in a sense that a lot of the direct testing that has been needed, for instance, for Xorg, for GCC, for Transition, and for a lot of other things have already been tried and proven and debugged, at least partially and in some case totally, at the Ubuntu front when Hori released, so that by the time Edge comes, I'd say about 80% of the problems have already been dealt with at the Ubuntu level because of their ability to move a bit faster since their package base is a bit smaller than us. Well, so to me, I mean, I think we've realized your Slink and a half goal in the sense that Ubuntu releases every 6 months. They do those kind of rapid transition. They do a lot of the raw work that is needed for us to be able to follow up more quickly, turnover more quickly with release. So I think an achievable goal would be for Ubuntu to keep on releasing every 6 months and then Debian every year or every year and a half. Then we would have the desired effect. And of course, during warty time, the collaboration between Ubuntu and Debian perhaps wasn't ideal, but now since Hori, it's improved dramatically. So I think we can achieve it that way. It's just a suggestion.
Okay, one thing is, my opinion was not the hard part was not how can we do the transition, but that a lot of people wanted to push their pet whatever into Sarge right now, and that delayed. And that's one of the basic decisions that we as a lead team made, that we say, we all know how is this pet issues. I have myself some pet issues, so, but we said, it might be pet issues, but either we can say we release, or we can just—it's not manageable. So we cut the pet release issues, pet release goals. So let's say set a pet goals. It's nice if we meet them. If not, we can release in any case. But now I have another question, just to you all, because actually, in my opinion, I was here with the expectation to speak with non-developers, so if they're not developers' questions, I would be happy to answer some of them.
I can try.
And please feel really free, because that you don't get to this technical level. Perhaps it's better to not speak as technical as now.
Fairly simple question. You mentioned four release goals for Edge, and they do not seem to fill up 18 months. Can you explain why it takes 18 months to fulfill these four release goals?
Well, okay. So I think the question is a bit different because actually we said okay, the Debian developers want to work on a lot of issues, and it's not as we say as soon as all the four goals targets are met, we release. But we say okay, we have certain assumption for the release. For example, as you said, the enterprise users push for large and predictable cycles for very good reason. Our developers want some time to work on new things. There happens a lot of development inside of Debian. Not only, we just import some new upstream source and we release, but there happens active development, so we need some time for it. And we noticed that with the last release, we frozen tool chain in August last year. Because we expect at that time that it might be a bit faster. And then we noticed that this was a bit bad for development of the tool chain. So we want to have some development cycle open. And in our opinion, as a release team, so the normal development cycle is open for about a year of normal development before we start on freezing. That does not mean that we forget now about testing. We will keep track of testing if something is broken there. We will try to push people into fixing it now. But I think it's a good thing to have also a normal development cycle and not only, oh, we will release about tomorrow.
Okay, I think, sorry, one last question and then we'll move on to the last.
Last question, and this is the most important question you will ever hear at this conference.
And of course, every question is the most important.
But this is vitally important for the future of Debian. Will the next version be 3.2 or 4.0?
Basically, I don't know. But let me just say something about the most important question. As every question is the most important, also every package is. We have, at the release team, we have very good, we know how to deal with such things. But actually, we don't know. But basically, if we would have decided about the release number of Sarge, let's say, 4 months ago, probably we would have gone for a new major release number. But at that time, it was already fixed up in so many places that we said better to have to go with 3.1 than with 4.0 at most places, and some with still with 3.1. Okay.
Thank you very much, Andreas.
Oh, thank you all.